talk to them. This, of course, is Mr. and Mrs. Sheppard from Baldwin, Long Island, our champion.
Morning, Merv.
Morning, Merv. Morning.
Good to see you. They were our champions from before. They, a couple of days ago, won a Somar piano.
Yeah, that's right.
Which was a nice gift. And today, of course, you're playing your hunch for a beautiful present, which we'll be telling you about in a minute. As we went off the air, well, the time has come, Mr. and Mrs. Sheppard. Once again, you're at that moment where you play for the grand prize. And right now, Johnny Olson's going to remind you what you're playing for today. Johnny, tell him.
It's a Triumph family fun sedan created by the Standard Triumph Motor Company of Great Britain. This stylish car will be the talk of the neighborhood. It delivers up to 40 miles per gallon, has plenty of leg and headroom, and when the rear seat folds down, provides 30 cubic feet of carrying space. This delightful car is yours if you win on Play Your Hunch.
That's an exciting grand prize.
Oh, wonderful.
I can picture the two of you driving right down the street. And that's a lovely gift. All right, observe very carefully our lovely little gal friend over here, Suzanne Storrs. She is holding the keys to the Triumph car. And in just a moment, Suzanne is going to be in position behind one of these Play Your Hunch doors, which, of course, like everything else on the show, is labeled X, Y, and Z. There's a signal. That means Suzanne is in position. All you have to do is tell me which door she's standing behind.
Merv.
That's very
immediately.
Immediately, right off the top of your head. What do you think?
No premonitions,
no,
but just playing a hunch and hoping for the best.
X. You think it's X?
I hope
they have selected X. Let's see how right they are. Let's open the doors. I'm sorry. I wished you good luck. You selected X. Suzanne, of course, was behind door Y, but the grand prize is still available for our next winners, and that might be you.
Could be.
But you have won yourselves a lovely prize.
Oh, yes.
Would you like to know what you've won?
Love it.
Tell them, Johnny.
Well, here's what you've won. It's a glamorous and exciting vacation for two, a round-trip flight from New York City to Miami, and a one-week stay at the Roney Plaza Hotel in Miami Beach, Florida. You'll have fun in the sun and elegant evenings. We'll include full seven-course dinners in the Imperial Room of the Roney Plaza Hotel. It's yours with compliments of Play Your Hunch.
Oh, very nice.
Well, you came out very well.
Thank you.
That's a lovely gift. Continue along with Play Your Hunch. Our challengers, the Molidor family here, are leading at 1-0. Let's see how you do on this round. May we have our next problem, please? Well, observe very carefully. Three beautiful figures here of some very celebrated young ladies. And, of course, they are labeled Miss X, Miss Y, and Miss Z. Of course, the heads aren't showing yet, but Mr. and Ms. Sheppard, are you going to play or pass?
We'll play,
Merv.
All right. Study these lovely young ladies very carefully. These enlarged photographs were loaned to us by Photoplay, America's leading movie magazine, incidentally. Here we have full-length photographic enlargements of famous celebrities. The faces are covered. One is Grace Kelly. Which figure actually belongs to the Princess of Monaco, Miss Grace Kelly? You talk it over and let me know. Is it Miss X? Give you a nice, good shot now. Miss Y?
X looks as if...
Look carefully. Huh? Or is it Miss Z? All right, Mr. and Ms. Sheppard, go ahead, talk.
Well, X has the dignity of a princess now. Y looks like a glamour girl during her movie career, and Z looks like Grace if she were Grace during her outdoor or summer days.
She used to, sir.
I don't know. They all look like Grace Kelly to me.
She used to wear, as I recall, pictures of her more or less classic style clothes and rather conservative, like Z.
I think when she was in the movies, though, she was
quite a glamour girl, too. Picture in a movie magazine that was taken as a casual shot, not a pose.
Could be.
Photograph.
I would eliminate X-Peg if I were you, but that's a hunch, a pure hunch. So between Y and Z, you make up the feminine mind.
I like Z.
You like Z?
You like Z, Ms. Sheppard?
Yeah.
Well,
all right, let's see who this is. They have selected Miss Z.
No.
That's Leslie Caron. She has stopped you so far. That leaves X and Y. Mr. and Mrs. Molidor, talk it over. What do you think? Which one is Grace Kelly?
Well, Y looks a little too glamorous. I don't think she went in for that sort of thing.
It just seems to me that I've seen this picture in X.
It's a pretty picture, aren't they?
Well,
no, Well, we stumped you on that one, didn't we? Aren't we clever, huh?
Oh, I tell
you. You don't trust us for a minute. We pull all kinds of tricks here on Player Hunch. We're going to continue. The score is 1-0 still in favor of our challengers, Mr. and Ms. Molidor. We'll be right back with you right after station identification.
And why? He looks Italian.
He looks like he's putting on, doesn't he?
Like he might wear a mustache.
I think he's...
Although he doesn't have any hair on his head.
Oh, it all might have gone right down and
might
come out
flipped.
On
the
I think why? I mean
X.
You're going to play your hunch on, there's
X.
A signal, on X,
X,
huh?
X, right.
All right, Mr. X, they have selected you, sir. Would you remove that handkerchief?
Oh.
Clean as a whistle, you're wrong. I'm sorry, that's a mistake. Ah, this is a confusing one. All right, Mr. Ms. Shepard, passes to you. Y or Z, talk it over.
Well, a lot of people who have thinning hair on top put mustaches, you know, to replace it. But that again may be one of those traps you set for us before with Grace Kelly.
The Z is more or less the Ivy League type from what we can see, and a lot of the college boys and Ivy League types go into these mustaches now. So it's...
Gee, this is going to be pure hunch. Reason tells me why, but the hunch tells me to go for Z, Peg.
That's very interesting. What do you think, Peg?
Come on, premonition. Let's go for Z.
We're going to go for
Z. The Ivy League boy.
Gentlemen, on my signal, wait a minute. On my signal, would you both remove your handkerchiefs at the same time? At the count of three. One, two, three.
Ah!
It's Z. You're absolutely right. I got to admit, in rehearsal, they confused me. I went right along with you and selected the other two. Mr. X, you are?
York Blumenfeld.
From where, York?
New York City.
What do you do for a living, York?
Trying to get into television production.
Well, look straight ahead. There might be quite a few folks out there looking at you. Thank you for being on. You, Mr. Y, are?
Irving Meyer.
Irving?
New York City.
New York City with which company?
Bear Stearns and Company, brokers.
Ah.
Brokers.
Well, you could use a mustache down on Wall Street. You know, you might look very good down there.
And a pencil.
And you, sir, are?
Bill Gillis.
I see. That's a very sporty one you got there. Do you keep care of that yourself?
Oh, yes, sir. Nobody else can touch it.
Yeah? How about the girlfriends? They ever complain?
The wife.
Oh, the wife. I almost
said
a terrible thing.
She has complained, but as you can see, I've still got it.
Boy, you sure have. Then you're the boss in that family, huh?
Well, you said it.
Yeah, I said it. I wanted to get you to say it, though. You're delightful, all of you, and I really appreciate it. Did we find out which company you're with, Mr. C?
I'm in business for myself. I'm in the insurance business.
Well, you can afford to have a mustache. Thank you all very much for being on Player Hunch. We appreciate it. Good morning, sir. Thank you. Delightful, gentlemen. Well, game is all tied up at one apiece. We'll be right back with you after this word from CBS Television. We go into the art world for our next problem. Observe three busts here. Of course, they are labeled X, Y, and Z. Now, Mr. and Ms. Shepard, it's up to you. You can play or pass.
We'll play.
All right, observe these classic-looking busts. Two of these gentlemen are famous Roman emperors. The third is just nobody in particular, an unknown taxpayer maybe of the same era. Look closely and tell me which is the bust of the unknown gentleman. Is it X? Is it Y? Or is it Z? Talk about it.
The hairdos in those days were pretty much the way the one on Z is, don't you think?
That's right.
And Y, of course, looks obviously as though it were someone.
One of the Caesars, perhaps,
yes.
Huh? X is just a fine, modern-looking boy.
There's a signal.
Now, what's the problem again?
Which one is Mr. Nobody? Two of them are of well-known Roman emperors. One is Nobody. Which one is Nobody?
I'd go along with X.
I think so, too.
You think it's X? All right, they're going to play their hunch on X, Rosemary. Would you hold up that card? And that's Augustus.
Oh.
That's incorrect. I'm sorry. The play passes to Mr. and Ms. Molidor. You have two to select from, Y and Z. Which one is Mr. Nobody?
Can we talk this over now, Murray?
Yeah, sure. Go right ahead. You'll win the game if you get it right. Which one do you think it is?
I think it's Z.
You think it's Z? Let me hold up this card.
No,
oh,
no.
Nobody! You have won by Your Hunch! Mrs. Molador didn't know she won. Let's find out who this is. This is Caesar. So we have winners on Play Your Hunch. Mr. and Ms. Sheppard, you have been delightful champions. You've won a Sommer piano and a trip to Florida. We do have going away presents for you. Johnny, tell them what we have in the way of going away presents.
Yes, we have the Polaroid camera for you and also a bottle of My Sin perfume by Lanvin. Compliments of Play Your Hunch.
Don't know what you're saying. They're all confused. Thank you so much. See you again soon. Mr. and Mrs. Molador, you are our new champions, and as we start the game tomorrow, you'll be going for the great big grand prize. We'll see you all tomorrow on Play Your Hunch. Bye.
Final presents by Susan Perrette. Play Your Hunch is a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production in association with the CBS Television Network.